It brings me great joy to introduce to you our 2017 Simeon Booker Award for Courage honorees. Please give a warm welcome to Mr. Terry Vickers and Mr. Ken Wadike.
I just want to say thank you all for having me here. I came out from California to receive this award, and it's such an honor to be tied to so many great people such as Simeon Booker with the award, but also tonight just learning more about the work that Terry does. And it blew me away, you know, to know that when my mom moved to South Central Los Angeles as a single mother with five kids, we relied on people like himself that gave us information on how to get into shelters that would help us and pointed us towards programs that really helped our family out, you know, because my mom, at that time, she relied on my dad for everything, and right after their divorce, she decided, you know, for the safety of my kids, I'm going to raise five kids on my own, and she did, and, you know, she never would have guessed that her baby son, you know, who was living in this homeless shelter, would grow up to be on the front lines of riots and protests and trying to de-escalate violence. And so much of that was, you know, the work of people like Terry that kind of pointed us in the right direction, but also getting to South Central Los Angeles in the 90s and experiencing the 92 riots, the Rodney King riots that took place there at such a young age. And it really left such an impression on me, even as a boy, you know, to know that I wanted to make a difference. And I always grew up with this mindset of not just sitting around and always asking, why doesn't someone do something about that? I see things and I say, I can do something about that. And it took a long time for me to get to that point. You know, I spent so many of my young adult life years just very insecure and introverted. I didn't talk to too many people when I was in school, aside from my own siblings. Kids were not nice to me when I was in high school and middle school because many of them knew that I lived in a homeless shelter. And so you just weren't the cool kid because of that. And so to have found my voice as an adult after just seeing so many of these riots and injustices and protests and things taking place and seeing them turn violent and so negative, I knew that I can have a voice in talking to people and being able to de-escalate the violence. And even though my work, my brand says free hugs when I show up to these things, it's really about the communication that we have with people that can bring a little bit of calm to many of the situations that we're seeing there. And just being able to teach people empathy and inclusion and to really listen to one another even when we're on opposing sides. I mean, that's the biggest problem right now is that everything in the media and so many things that we look at today, it's actually dividing us, especially social media. People are just taking sides against one another and no one is really listening to each other anymore. So now so much of my work is to bring people together, and it's just an honor to be acknowledged for that type of work of just trying to bring people together. And I think that we need so much of that right now. We're letting politics divide us. We're letting our social media feeds and everything else divide us. And we just need more people stepping up as peacemakers to really try to bring people together and create change in this world. So I thank you all for having me here, and especially for the award and acknowledging the work that we're doing out there on the front lines, and especially with what you're doing with homeless families. It means so much to me. I don't think I could be standing here today if it wasn't for people like yourself that would, you know, point us in the right direction and come into the shelters. One of my favorite people as a kid that a lot of, I don't often share this story, but when I was that kid living in the shelter, I remember around the time I was 13 years old, and I was constantly asking my mom, how come everybody else has everything and we have nothing? And she said, it gets better from here. And I remember there was a guy when I was living in LA, he would always come down to the shelter every week and he would read books to us. And because of that, even since 13 years old, and I'm an old man now, but since then, my favorite book or story is The Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe from the Chronicles of Narnia, because this guy would come down there and he would make us forget that we were homeless and all we cared about was going into this land of Narnia. My whole life I was trying to find this Turkish delight that they talk about in the story, because I'm like, this guy was willing to sell his soul for some Turkish delight. Like, I didn't care about being homeless in those moments. I just cared about what people were able to provide for me to just make me think bigger. I can't remember a single dollar that people gave us back then, and I'm sure they did, but it's not the money that makes a difference. It's the impact that we have on people's lives. And for me, it was people who come in and they share stories and they inspire us and they tell us to dream big and think big. And it was because of that that, you know, the people that I would meet along the way, a track coach that I met along the way that told me I can be great, and I believed that, and that got me to college. It got me from college to being able to run professionally for a couple of years, all because someone just believed in me, rather than seeing me walk through the halls as this shy and introverted kid with my head down all the time and my hands in my pocket, couldn't even make eye contact with people when I would speak to them. And now I'm going out onto the front lines and boldly stepping up in people's face. I never could have imagined that I would be that person, but I know I only became that person because of the people who popped up in my life and inspired me along the way. And so I just want to encourage everybody here to try and be that more for the people in the world. People are hurting out there today. People are depressed. They're frustrated with so many of the things that we're seeing all around us. And sometimes we just need someone to come up and say, it's going to be all right. Or to give us some words of encouragement, or pat you on the back, or give you that hug to let you know it's going to be all right. You know, you'd be surprised how many people that I give a hug and they just cry on my shoulder, complete strangers. It happens in the airport all the time. It happens as I go and visit schools. And I let people know, look, I don't know your story, you know, but I just want to let you know it gets better and you matter. So then that's what people are really fighting for right now. We see all of these movements, these organizations. Everyone is fighting to proclaim that they matter. So let's show them that. Thank you.